I'm Jedi-Jack Penguin, and today I'm bringing you another haul video. So I got some stuff from some yard sales that I went to both this week and last week. I also have one other item that I got off Lego.com when it released. So let's get right into this haul video by taking a look at the first item that we got. We got Lego Dimensions, the starter pack for the Xbox 360. Sadly, this did not come with the actual game. But I did get like almost all the pieces included for this set, that being set number 71173. Right here I do have a very, very, very damaged box for this set, so that I'm just gonna toss right there. Hopefully that can just stay where it is. There we go, we got the starter pack box right there. Along with that, I did actually get the Lego Dimensions poster, which is very nice, and we also got the instructions for the overall, like, gate right there. We also have the original sticker sheet, which was unused, which was very nice, as well as, of course, the toy pad itself, and then we do have the actual building right here, which we did get some extra pieces with this as well. So pretty much like all the pieces were included right here, trying to balance all this stuff very nice. We are missing one of the wheels for the Batman vehicle though, however, and then we are also missing the capes for Batman and Gandalf right there. So those are all of the stuff that I got for Lego Dimensions. Minus that I did also get along with this, I did get the Nia Fun Pack, that being set number 71216 right here, which this I think is sealed. It is opened on the side, but you know, I got all of this for $12 at a yard sale. Very nice overall pickup right there for all that Lego Dimensions stuff. I don't know how much it goes for on the aftermarket or anything as of this time, but you know, very nice just for like the pieces that you get and the minifigures. Continuing with the Lego stuff that I got from yard sales, we have set number 10695, the Lego Creative Building Box with 580 pieces, which I did actually go through to make sure that all of the pieces were here. They were not. I am missing about like 6 or 7 pieces in there. I did like bag it up and whatnot. If you look inside, I have 2 bags of all of the pieces and then the instructions for the models that are included. But you know, very nice that I did get this and some of the other stuff that I will be showing you in the next couple of minutes. I got for a total of $10, which is really nice. Which here is some of the other pieces and stuff that we do have within this lot right here, which we can just go down right here. We also have some other instruction booklets for some other sets that may or may not be included. We have a little bit of Minecraft, a little bit of City. We have this one little piece right here from a Ninjago set, but none of the other stuff is included for that. We have a lot of creator stuff as well. We also have a little bit of Lego Batman movie stuff hidden in within here, which we also do get some minifigures within this yard sale haul lot, which not too many, but you know, here are all of the minifigures that came with it. Also, this base plate also came with it. We also have this weird like zombie guy from Scooby-Doo right here. Might as well just take a nice zoom in right there. He also came with the tree. We did not get the Mystery Machine, though I already own that set. We also have Spider-Man and Electro behind them, which is very nice. We have the Joker minifigure from the Lego Batman movie with his balloon jetpack going on right there. We have some Minecraft characters. We have a baby mushroom as well as a creeper. We have one of those little Lego games characters, which I don't know what that goes to, but you know, it was included. And then we do have a lot of Lego City stuff as well as a little Dalmatian dog right there. Very nice. And that's pretty much all for the minifigures that I found within this lot, which, you know, wasn't too many, but, you know, for $10, I did get a lot of very nice pieces within this lot. And now just to push this to the side, along with this, I did also get some other stuff, which, you know, I already started building the one other set right here, which I did finish, which was this Lego Creator robot character right here, which was very nice. That is set number 31034, as shown on the instructions behind it. We also have the instructions for Lego Creator set number 31023 right there, which is that very nice looking helicopter. I don't know if that's all there, but I know I at least have the wings for it. And, you know, might as well just toss this over here for right now. I am starting to run out of space with all of this stuff that I'm getting. I am building a lot of different sets at the same time. I've also started to, like, sell some of the duplicate sets that I've been getting as well. So if you guys want to support the channel, you guys can check in the description below for my eBay account, where I'll be posting new LEGO stuff weekly. Continuing forward with the stuff that I got from yard sales, we have a bunch of dollar movies that I ended up getting. The first one we have right here is the Star Wars Animated Adventures, the Ewoks right here, which this is something that I just got just for fun. You know, I've never seen this before. You know, it's just something like something weird that I've never seen before, so, you know, I decided, you know, might as well pick it up and take a look and see what it's like. We have another DVD, that being the All Dogs Go to Heaven movie right here. Finally, happy to get this. This was actually sealed. I opened it, and it's in very nice condition and everything, of course. Next, we have Batman Begins right here, which this is a nice Blu-ray disc right here. $1 for that as well. Very nice that I got that. And finally, for this lot of movies, we have Jurassic World, which this is the Blu-ray DVD and digital HD, which I was actually able to get the digital version from this, and it was pre-opened when I actually bought it. I got that for $1 as well, which is also just very awesome that I got it for $1. And then finally, last week for 25 cents, which you might have already seen this on my Instagram, I got Star Wars The Clone Wars, which this was the Blu-ray version, not the DVD, which I already own the DVD. It just decided to upgrade it for 25 cents. I felt like it was worth buying it. It's in very nice condition. And that pretty much sums up all of the movies that I got. Now to the one item that I bought off LEGO.com back when it released, that being LEGO Brickheads set number 40367, Lady Liberty, that being Brickheads number 93 right here, which this is just a very beautiful Brickheads. I really can't wait to open this up. You guys can expect a review for this particular item sometime this week, since I am planning on spending most of the beginning of July looking at the newer sets that release for LEGO Harry Potter, which I'm really excited to get my hands on. Also, along with this LEGO Brickheads item, I did make an order off LEGO Bricks and Pieces, which you guys will be seeing me doing a special video based off what I got from there in a couple of days when I actually get the order. I don't know if it's gonna be this week, or if it's gonna be next week, or if it's gonna be, like, not even this month, so, you know. Still, it's just something for you guys to look forward to with some very interesting and exciting pieces that I found. So yeah, that pretty much sums up everything that I got from yard sales and whatnot. Trying to just zoom out so then we can take a better look at everything that I got. I got a lot of LEGO stuff right here and a lot of very nice movies. So yeah, that's pretty much all for this video. Remember to like and subscribe and hit that bell icon so you know every time I upload a new video. So yeah, that's it for now, and I will see you next time. Bye!